Keith, we look forward to hearing first from Lee Ziady, who is a nominee for the office of deacon, married to Lika, whom you know quite well, investment strategist with Morgan Stanley, been in our church for quite some time, nominated to be a deacon, has promised he'll keep it shorter than he did last time he spoke.
Thank you. It's always a risk for Brother Jim to have somebody up here. I know. But one page. This is it. Right here. One page. First, I want to thank you for the nomination. I'm humbled and honored to serve. Not sure who exactly behind this nomination, but you might want to meet me outside after church. Joking aside, we have been members here since 2008, first at Covenant and now here at SVC. I have truly grown spiritually here at Stevens Valley more than any other time in my Christian walk. Our church family is full of mature Christian believers that I love and respect. As a deacon at Stevens Valley, I hope that God will use me to serve and give back as I have been given. Little background, I was born in a Christian home in Beirut, the capital of the country of Lebanon. I was fortunate enough to attend an American missionary school. That's unusual there. Usually you learn French. Chapel attendance was required daily. It was there, I believe, when I first heard the gospel at a very young age. I always remember Isaiah 55:11. My word goes forth and never returns void. When I was 15, the country of Lebanon descended into a civil conflict between its Christians and Muslim citizens. My family was one of the few fortunate ones able to immigrate to the U.S. early on before things got really bad. The conflict transformed into a full-blown civil war, devastating and tearing the country apart for the next 15 years. Actually, it still has its effect on them today. I just want to say, you know, we always say if you're born here in the States, or if you come here to the States, you won the lottery. Coming to America felt like a different world, or maybe even another planet. At age 15, this was not exactly what you call easy. A kid torn away from his home, friends, culture, just a total identity loss. Total identity loss, a perfect recipe for rebellion. And rebellion it was. The 20 years that followed, I did it my way. And it did not turn out well. At age 35, I surrendered my life to Jesus with only one condition. One condition, that he would reveal himself to me. And reveal he did. Surprised is a weak expression. Blown away or amazed is much more better description of how I felt. The Apostle Paul was riding a horse on the road to Damascus. I was driving a Ford on the road to Mount Juliet. I did not run over anyone or hit a telephone pole, but I knew that second that he heard me. This was by far the best decision I've ever made. I would highly recommend to anyone who's yet on the fence. Here I want to stop and thank God for my family, my faithful wife, Lika, my daughter, Christina, and son, Andrew, and mom and dad that never gave up on me. Today, 26 years later, I can truly declare him faithful. He knew me and loved me long before I knew him. Thank you.
Short.
I'm done. I told you.